The customer has complained that his home complete load turns off when the air conditioner circuit is turned on. So, let's see if we can repair this circuit board in this video because someone has already tried to repair it. Then, this circuit board came to me for repair. I think the soldering iron has been used on the EEPROM IC. Other than this, a resistor is present here. Let me show you the number of the resistor. The resistor number is R926. I can see work has been done on this resistor as well. I don't know whether it has been replaced with a new one, or only removed and then mounted back on the circuit board. Other than this, let me show you the circuit board from the backside. The IGBT has been removed from the circuit board. This IGBT seems good to me. But work has been done here as well. This is the IGBT driver circuit here. A diode is usually installed here. The number is the diode 14. It is missing from the circuit board. I have tested this IGBT off the camera, but I rechecked it after a while, and it is showing a problem now. I have placed the negative probe on the base pin of the IGBT, and the red probe on this pin of the IGBT. The voltage drop is 0.590 shown on the multimeter. I will now change the sides of the probes. I will keep it on these pins and keep it checking randomly on all the pins. Now, I will change the side of multimeter probes again. As I place the probes on the multimeter now, you can see a quite decrease in the voltage drop. The voltage drop should not decrease. Before it, the voltage drop decreases to less than 0.2 volts. If the voltage drop is decreasing so much, then the IGBT will be considered bad. Let me make you understand what components are installed in it. Then, I will help you understand the circuit diagram and how it functions. This is the gate pin of the IGBT. The pin in the center is the collector pin. This is the emitter pin of this IGBT. The emitter is joined with the ground trace. The collector is joined with the positive supply of the bridge rectifier. This is a PNP transistor mounted here. The PNP transistor is installed to discharge the gate pin of the IGBT. The switching on the IGBT is quite high. That is why it is essential to discharge the gate pin. In case it is not discharged, then, the IGBT could go bad because the resistance between the pins will occur for more time. Then this IGBT will go bad every time. Other than this, what is the function of the diode in this circuit? I will explain that going further in the video. Two transistors are mounted here. This is the NPN and the PNP transistor. The NPN transistor is attached to the microcontroller because the microcontroller sends the signals of 3.3 volts on this NPN transistor first. The positive volts are supplied as signals on the base pin of this NPN transistor. This is how it turns on, and the voltages are supplied to the base of the PNP transistor. A negative voltage supply is required to turn it on. The negative voltage supply is given to it from the output of the NPN transistor. 15 volts are over here. These 15 volts stand here when the PNP transistor is not triggered. You can hear the beep sound from the multimeter. When this PNP transistor opens up, the voltages are passed through the upper pin of the PNP transistor. These voltages pass through this capacitor, and it is charged up. A chip ceramic capacitor is mounted here on the circuit. Then, this 4424 IC is mounted next. The voltages stand on this IC pin number 6. The microcontroller then sends the 3.3 voltage signals on the 2 and 4 number pins of this IC. Both these pins are joined together. When the signals come on this IC, the 15 voltages that are standing on the 6 number pin of this IC, it turns on and passes them through the 5 and 6 number pins of the IC. These pins are attached to the IGBT gate pin. When these voltages are passed through the gate pin, the other two pins turn on. The switching is of 20 kHz. I will show you that on the oscilloscope. Someone has removed the diode from this circuit board. This pin is the anode, and the upper pin is the cathode. Both the anodes are connected with one another. I will check it. When I check it in continuity mode, it shows us reading, which means it is short-circuited. I will now put the multimeter on diode mode. Now, I will place the multimeter probes at any polarity. The diode traces show a short circuit. Now, I will change the sides of the probes. Still, this diode trace is showing a short circuit. As I have shown the IGBT driver circuit physically, I will now explain its circuit diagram to you. Now, whatever the unit is, AC electricity is used to turn it on. When AC electricity is passed through it, after being filtered, it moves towards the bridge rectifier. The bridge rectifier converts the DC to AC electricity. Then, the DC electricity makes the rest of the circuit work. The microcontroller turns on, and the rest of the functions occur. But simultaneously, the microcontroller measures how much AC and DC electricity is moving in the circuit, then power the rest of the circuit board. If the AC or DC voltages are low in the circuit for some reason, then the microcontroller receives the signals and power of the circuit and shows an error code. This circuit board is designed to drive the compressor. The inverter compressor is operated at variable speeds. Sometimes, its speed is kept high and sometimes low. This circuit board is used to do it. When the compressor is driven, the voltages, whether the AC or DC, fluctuate. The PFC circuit is installed on the board to control this fluctuation. The PFC circuit refines the DC voltages to supply the voltages to the compressor for smooth operation. So when does the PFC circuit turn on? These two capacitors are mounted on the circuit board. These are of 500 volts, 680 microfarads. When the compressor turns on, these capacitors start to discharge. The circuit measuring the DC links sends signals to the microcontroller that the voltages in these capacitors are weakened, so the PFC is turned on again to ensure smooth functioning in the system. The microcontroller turns on the PFC circuit, and then charges these capacitors. When the microcontroller receives signals that the capacitor voltages are weak, it sends voltages to the NPN transistor. But what was the need for the NPN and the PNP transistor over here? The gate of this IGBT turns on at 1.5 volts, which makes the current flow from the emitter to the collector. The microcontroller works at 3.3 volts. This microcontroller turns on at 3.3 volts. It can easily drive the IGBT, but it can't do it as 1.5 volts minimum is required to trigger the gate pin. Then it needs a minimum of 50 milliamperes of current to power it on. The microcontroller works on max 20 milliamperes. If more current is drawn through the microcontroller than this, it will burn. So a difference in the current is 30 milliamperes. To fulfill this difference of 30 milliamperes, this IGBT driver circuit is used to drive the IGBT. All the supplies from the microcontroller are outputted as positive voltages. The voltage supply to the IGBT is passed in positive. That is why a PNP transistor is used here. The base of the PNP transistor, through which it is turned on, it needs a negative supply to turn on. For that, the NPN transistor is used. The NPN base pin requires the positive supply to turn on. The microcontroller sends a signal or supply of 3.3 volts to the base pin of the NPN transistor. Thus, this transistor turns on. After the transistor is turned on, the ground is on the emitter pin, which moves towards the collector. The base of the PNP transistor turns on with a negative supply, which makes the other two pins work. Thus, the 15 volts are moved from the emitter to the collector, and are passed through this IC. We will also look at this resistor installed here and the other installed here. The 10 kilo-ohms resistor is used for the pull-down, and the 2 kilo-ohms resistor is used for the pull-up. So let me explain what are its functions. Suppose the microcontroller has given 3.3 volts to this NPN transistor. It will turn on, and then it turns the supply off. Some floating voltages may still be present here. Suppose 1.5 volts are present here, which means the transistor is still slightly turned on. As it is turned on, it will be a problem. This path is here as a pull-down resistor to make floating voltages flow through this resistor toward the ground. When these voltages are grounded, the floating voltages over here are zero, which will turn off the transistor. Now, let me explain how the pull-up resistor works. Usually, 15 volts are present at this point. They come through the resistor from the 15-volt supply. The PNP transistor does not turn on if a 15-volt supply is present here. It will remain off. When the NPN transistor turns on, the negative voltages move here. Due to this, the 15 volts that are present here move back. The negative zero or ground voltages turn on the PNP transistor. To remove these ground voltages from the circuit when the NPN transistor is turned off, these ground voltages are pulled up with the help of the resistor. To make the 15 volts, return to the PNP transistor base pin to turn it off. If these pull-up and pull-down resistors are not used, this circuit will cause problems, and this system will be a failure. Now, I will explain how this IC works. The microcontroller turns on all these transistors. The 15 volts will move towards the 6-number pin of the IC. The microcontroller will again generate signals over here for this point. A 100 ohms resistor is installed here. The microcontroller can generate 3.3 volts, not more than this. The voltages will move to the pin 2 and 4 of the IC. The pin 2 and 4 are joined with one another. The manufacturer of this IC says that if you are using one pin for the signals, then you will have to join these two points together. Then, this IC will work properly. Join the output pins so that the IC keeps functioning properly. Following the manufacturer's instructions, the input and the output pin are joined together. This IC will increase the amplitude of 3.3 volts to 15 volts. The signals over here are almost 3.3 volts. The amplitude of the wave will also increase here. If the frequency of the switching here is 20 kHz, the frequency of the switching over here will also be 20 kHz. This means the duty cycle at the input will be the same as the output. Only the amplitude will be increased on the output. These 15 volts will move further on the gate of the IGBT. But before it, some components are attached to it. Let me explain these as well. This is that diode whose traces were showing a short circuit. When 15 volts will move, it will not be able to move from here. A diode is installed with it. A barrier is made across the diode. The positive voltages could not move through it. 15 volts will find another path through the 1 kilo ohm resistor, and then further moves over here. A PNP transistor is installed here. Suppose positive voltages are supplied on the base of this PNP transistor. It will not turn on, which will make no difference. So, these 15 volts will move towards the gate of the IGBT. A 10 kilo ohms resistor is joined with the gate pin. The voltages will not be able to move through this high-value resistor. The 15 volts will eventually trigger the gate pin. The emitter and collector will be joined together. After they are joined, resistance will be produced here. Now, what happens when this resistance is produced? Let me explain. This reactor charges up due to the resistance produced. When the capacitor is discharging, the reactor will be charged. As soon as the reactor is charged, the capacitor will charge again. This reactor is charged in DC supply, but this reactor is discharged with AC voltages. A diode is installed with it to convert it to DC. This cycle keeps going. Let me explain why this PNP transistor is installed here. Discharging the gate of the IGBT is very important because if it is not discharged, this could make the IGBT go bad. This 1 kilo ohm resistor is installed moving towards the PNP transistor. When the supply from the microcontroller is turned off, this point will be grounded with negative zero voltages, which turn on the PNP transistor, and if any floating voltages are present here, these floating voltages will move towards the ground, and will be discharged. And this is how the IGBT will also be discharged. Now let me tell you for what purpose this diode is installed. Now, when the switching of 20 kHz occurs here, it happens quite rapidly. When the positive voltages are turned off, the negative voltages start to pass through it. It is possible that the negative spike could be generated here. This negative spike could disturb the circuit. That is why this diode is installed here. Because if the negative spike is present, it will move through this trace. It will move across the diode. After passing through, it vanishes. This is the reason the diode was installed here. I will now test this circuit board again. I will first test this resistor over here. This should be a 10 kilo ohms resistor. Yes, it is a 10 kilo ohms resistor. Now, let's check the next resistor. This is a 10 ohms resistor. The resistor opposite to it is 50 ohms. Let's check this resistor next. It is also fine. Now, let's check this next resistor. It is a 1 kilo ohms, which is absolutely fine. Let's check the next resistor. It is 100 ohms, which is fine. Now, the next resistor. It is a 5 kilo ohms, absolutely fine. After the capacitor, a resistor is mounted, which is a 2 kilo ohms resistor. It is also fine. The next resistor is 10 kilo ohms. It is also okay. Next is 5 kilo ohms, which is also fine. All these resistors installed here are fine. They have no issue. Let's check this transistor as well. For this, I will put the multimeter on diode mode. We know that this is its base pin, this is the emitter, and this is the collector pin. I will check the pins between the base and the collector. 0.658 is the voltage drop on its pins. I will reverse the multimeter probes. 0.593 voltage are here. Let's check on these pins now. 0.833 volts are present here. The reading is shown across all the points of the transistor. The reading is shown here. This means that this transistor is short-circuited. It has a leakage. It does not show zero value directly. I will remove it from the circuit and replace them with a new one. Other than this, I will temporarily remove this IGBT from the circuit board, and then I will check it. I have replaced the components in the circuit board. I have replaced this PNP transistor with a new one. I have also installed the diode that was missing here in the circuit board. I have also replaced this 10 kilo ohms resistor. I will test this circuit board with an oscilloscope. The IGBT is not in the circuit. I have placed the oscilloscope probes over there. On the other hand, I installed an AC voltage regulator. I will control the AC voltages through it to check what result we get on the oscilloscope. I have powered on the voltage regulator. 226 volts are passing out from it. The circuit board has turned on. The red and green lights are blinking. I will gradually decrease the voltages. Let's see whether the IGBT driver IC works or not. No voltages are present on the gate pin of the IGBT driver. Let's see whether the voltages pass through the gate or not. And see this, the voltages have started to pass. I will decrease the graph's amplitude on the oscilloscope. I have pressed the measure button on the DSO. The amplitude of the voltages is 15 volts. It is working on 20 kHz. The width is 44 microseconds. The max voltages are 15 volts. I will gradually increase the voltage as soon as I have increased the voltages. The signals have turned off, which means the capacitors are fully charged. And that is why the circuit has turned it off. When the circuit board operates the compressor, it will keep the IGBT turning on and off. Let's check this PNP transistor once again. I will check it with its base to the collector. This is the voltage drop, which is 0.656. I will check it with the emitter. It is 0.658. Now, I reverse the polarity of the probes. The voltage drop reading is not showing after changing the polarity of the probes. Some voltages are shown, and then they are dropped. This means the leakage in this transistor has been fixed. Let's check this diode now. This 50 and 10 ohms resistor is mounted on both sides of the diode. A loop is made here. It is normal for the diode to show a short circuit here. It shows a short circuit on both sides. The resistance values of these resistors are very low, which is why, instead of the diode value, it shows a short circuit here. If this PNP transistor is short-circuited, then this IGBT will short-circuit again and again. This will trip the complete load of the home or the breaker it is installed with. It has been fixed now, and I will return this circuit board to the customer. I am tired now, and I run on coffee. So buy it for me on Patreon. Click the link on the screen to visit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.